Hello, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome back to another BJ&Co Minecraft video. We're still in our Skyfactory world, which means it's tutorial time, guys. We're continuing on our achievement guide, and this time we're walking you through the beginning of the farming age to show you guys how to get any of these achievements done if you are stuck on them, or just to give you a helping hand if you want to speed things up. But first off, if you guys have been enjoying these and you want to help support the channel, we very much appreciate a smashing of that like button down below. So if you want to see updates and when our channel goes live, you can hit that sub button. And if you do, it really helps us out because we're making a big push to hit that 1,000 sub mark. We're getting close, less than 100 to go. So we greatly appreciate anything that you can do to help us out. And if you really, really like this stuff and really want to support us, consider checking out our Patreon page, which is linked in the description down below. There's also all sorts of cool stuff there, like our Discord. If you want to join and hang out with the crew, you can check it out there. But let's get on into this. So, four things to do today. Watering can, cow in a jar, farming spaces, and an Inferium speed. This one's not too tough. Most of these you should be able to figure out. First off, watering can. So this one is, you can NEI it to sort it out. It's super easy. But if we come on over here, all we need to make this extra utilities watering can. Now, there is a couple of different watering cans. In this one, some of them require Inferium stuff. So you can see here, and it requires a fertilization core, which requires all of this stuff. So that's a little later on for right now. Even the tiny progressions one, it's not too bad, but it requires this watering can already. So that's the one we're looking at, the extra utilities to watering can. And pretty simple. What we need here is 4 stone and a bowl. And if you do not know how to make a bowl because you don't use it very often, all you need is 3 planks in a shape like this to get the bowl. Once you have the bowl, drop in the middle here and bam, you have your watering can done. Now the watering can is kind of neat because it just lets you go to a water source of some sort. Here, let's just go to my crucible. Wow, it's not going to let me pick up water from the crucible. That sucks. So we'll go over to my infinite water source that I've made over here by my sheeps. Well, that's what there's now. And you can see if we just hold it on here, right click it, and the left you can see it's filling up with water. There's also a green bar underneath it in the toolbar at the bottom that's filling up. And once it's full, you can right click to water. You can see there's some little water effects. If we, wow, that was stupid of me. Ugh. Okay, if we use water, it kind of acts a little bit like bone meal and helps things grow a little bit faster. But all in all, it's not the quickest of things ever. Like, it's slowly helping this stuff grow, but nothing crazy. Nothing too crazy. So, that's how you make it. Now, if you want, I did make an infinite water source over there, but seeing as we've got tons of mod packs here, I just want to show you one that I find super helpful in this mod pack, and it's its own infinite water source. All you need is a bucket of water, 3 pieces of wood, or 5 pieces of wood, and 3 pieces of iron, and this makes you a sink. And the sink is fantastic because it itself is a water source. You just right click on it and you can get as much as you need. And you can just keep doing that over and over and over and over and over again. So, cool one to make, simple and easy. Thought I'd add that in as a little bit of bonus for you, but get back to what we're doing. Watering can is done, so it'll help you out with your farming as we go along. Capture cow in a jar. I'm going to skip this one over just a little sec because it might be beneficial to have some farming spaces down first in order to get an area to spawn cows. Now, we do have an area to spawn cows from previous, the passive mob farm, sort of, kind of. But this one's more fun. We'll save it for last. So farming space for several crops. Most of you should know how to do this. It is just how you would do it in the regular Minecraft. You need your water source for it somehow. So this is kind of my animal spawning area. You don't have to have the water. You just need the grass to have animal spawning. But up here, I've done this. And this is just so that my water sources don't fall through. So I've kind of got nice little raised beds. Making some headway there. And again, if you're just using the base Minecraft stuff, you can, from your water source, 4 in every direction. As long as you hoe it, then you can start planting as much as you want in here and get some get some seeds growing on you. So here I'm getting a little bit of wheat going on. I would strongly suggest getting wheat going on because A, it might help you to get a cow in a jar. And B, if you plan on doing chickens, which is friggin' fantastic in this mod pack, you're gonna need a heck ton of wheat. So here you can see up here, we've got space for, we're just not even gonna talk about that. That is the worst placement I've ever seen of that water. Savvy, what have you done? Why are you trying to help me? So farming space here, I've got one second one that will clean up a little bit more so that we can plant some of the other stuff that we've got. So farming space done, simple and easy. Room for, I mean, there we could easily pop out about 8 different crops. I like to make one full one per crop, but it all depends how much you're needing to use the crops. So the next thing that we are going to do is craft an Inferium seed. Well, that one's not too hard. This one's NEI-able as well. But right here, it's one seed, which you should have gotten a bunch of through your sifting by now. And if you've planted some of them, like I have with the wheat, you should be getting more and more of them. And then all you use is Inferium Essence. And this Inferium Essence you get from killing any type of mod. It's a random drop trance, so that can be both passive, which are like your cows and your pigs and your sheep and that sort of stuff, or active, which is, or enemies, so your zombies, your creepers, your skeletons, all that sort of stuff. They all have a chance of dropping this Inferium Essence. And all you need is one seed, 8 of the essence, and boom, you get one of them. And I've got a few of them queued up here, so let's get all 6 of them. And now these are kind of interesting. The Inferium is kind of the base crafting item in relation to the mystical agriculture. So, let's actually get 6, man. Come on, do it right. So you can see we'll plant these here and these will grow and then these will allow us to get more Inferium essence. And you're gonna want lots of Inferium essence because if we take a look at the mystical agriculture stuff, we can see all sorts of interesting things here. So these are all the different mystical agriculture. There's 3 different pages of it. It's got its own armor and weapons and everything. You can see here there's an Inferium helmet that's made out of ingots. The ingots themselves are mixed with having an essence ingot with Inferium essence. And the essence, well, we can get into that later on when we go down that route. But if we take a look here, where's my other essences? Here. So Prudentium requires 4 Inferium and an Infusion Crystal. If we go to kind of the next level up, I mean, this should make sense. Intermedium takes 4 of the previous one. Superium takes 4 of the Intermedium. Supremium takes 4 of the Superium. So you kind of got to work your way all the way up to get it. So you're going to need, you know, if one of these takes 4 of these, and then one of these takes 4 of these, which means it takes 16 of these. And if one of these takes 4 of these, which takes 16 of these, which takes 40, 64 of this, you see where it's going. So then this one's going to take 200 and change of that. Like, you're going to need a lot of this stuff. So there is different levels of Inferium crops that we can get, but we just built the base level seed so far. There's lots of, if you plan on exploring mystical agriculture and things like, you know, the Supremium furnace that's 100% more efficient, you're going to want lots of this, lots and lots and lots of this. So strongly suggest checking it out. I really enjoy mystical agriculture. It's kind of fun. So that is that. We have made our seed. We've planted our seed. So now for the cow in the jar. So we have left this to last for a couple of reasons. Actually, let's see. Can I make these grow for you guys first? There, you can see they slowly grow a little bit. So, cow in a jar. Why did I leave it to last? Well, first off, passive mobs can be a pain in the butt sometimes. When I initially spawned my guys in, I only had the one. I got a chicken and a rooster, and nothing else would spawn after the fact. You can see right now, all I've got is some sheeps, and I don't want sheeps. I don't want any sheeps at all. We'll leave that for Mikey. Wink. Mikey, I hope you watch this. I really hope you watch this. It's been a long time. I hope you still check out our stuff. But, you know, you can always keep killing off what you've put in there and waiting and waiting, and hopefully you get some cows to come out. Hopefully. But, that can take a while. So one of the neat things that the EX compression mod adds, or as well, is this thing called a cow bait. So this kind of helps you. You need two wheat, and you can make the bait itself. So that's why it's good to get that wheat farm on the go right away. And this cow farm, what you need is you need kind of blocks from their environment. So I easily go with just grass blocks. We've got them already and they work well. And you need some water close by. And then you just right click to drop it down. And the bait will work in this environment, move out of range so you don't scare the animals. So if you just move out of the range, eventually, if you're far enough away, then a cow will spawn for you. So there, you can guarantee yourself a cow spawn instead of waiting and waiting and waiting. But then, how the heck do we get a cow in a jar? Well, first things first, we need a jar. Why is my jar not working? What? What did I screw up with this? So we're looking to get the cow in the jar. And the cow in the jar, we need an anvil, we need a cow, we need a milk jar. The milk jar... That's why it's not ready to go. Jeez, I try to prepare myself and I screw these things up. So, we need some milk. You didn't see that. So once we have the milk, we jump into here, we put it in here, and we get our milk jar! Boom! So, now that we've got the milk jar, we need a cow, which... we're waiting for, but I may have one already. It's like I planned for this, guys. So we've got our cow, and then last but not least, what we need is an anvil. So we're just gonna craft one up here. Anvils, they're a little expensive, might take you a while to get, but you need your 3 blocks of iron as well as 4 ingots. And boom, we've got our anvil. Now, all we need to do is we need to get the cow into the jar. So we're just gonna drop our jar down. We're gonna make ourselves, that sucked. That was horrible, man, horrible. Who taught this guy how to build? Okay, so we've got our kind of an area set up so that we can place, what we'll be doing is we'll be placing the cow down and then placing the anvil down as well. So let's get our anvil ready to go. And we'll place our cow right there. We'll place our anvil right there. And pop goes the cow. And now, why would you want a cow in a jar? Well, if you notice at the top at our Walia, it's showing milk stored. So it's actually filling up with milk. So this is an endless supply of milk. It holds 8 buckets at a time. A bucket is 1,000 of the whatever you want to call that, millibuckets, I think is what they go by. So that's that. There, we've got our cow in a jar. So all in all, not a too crazy intense episode, guys, but we knocked all 4 of those out. We do have some more to go in the farming age that we will tackle next time, which is we'll be looking at the matic. We'll be looking at starting full-on farms, which we kind of, I mean, we could almost say that that's done. But we'll touch on it a bit more like next time. We're going to get some snan going on, do some sugarcane. And then we actually need to automate some resource collection from chickens. Ooh, I talked about chickens earlier. That'll be very interesting to get in on that. And I might even have some tips from the community, too. We've teed up with a couple people on Reddit who said they've got some chicken tips. So if you guys have ideas that want to help out or tips and tricks that you guys want to share, we'd love to hear them. Feel free to comment down below. Shoot us a message. We always love to hear from you guys and watch me crash a game. That was so weird. Hey, and there, see our cow bait worked. There's the cow. The cow's killing me, guys. I'm going to die. But you can see our bait's gone. So the bait worked pretty quickly. That's awesome. So that's it for this one, guys. If you have been enjoying it, don't forget to smash that like button and show your support. So hit that sub button. Help us get to the 1,000 subs. And as always, if you really, really want to help us out, you can check out our Patreon page. For as little as $1 a month, you can help support the channel as well as see your names as a supporter show up in the end credits that are coming right now. So thank you very much for watching, and we'll catch you guys all next time.